To repair or disassemble your Samsung Galaxy Ace 5830, you will need a small Phillips size 00 and a bladed screwdriver and a thin plastic separation tool of some kind. If you have a damaged touchscreen or digitizer, you can find new ones easily online. Try and make sure the one you buy comes with double-sided tape already applied to the back. If this is missing on your new screen, you'll need to use fresh double-sided mobile phone tape. This is a Scotch brand 3M and is extremely sticky and flexible compared to normal household tape. If you have damage around the outside of the case or the bezel, this can be easily replaced with a new rear cover. This one also came with a new home button. You might also need to use a heat source of some kind. This is a hot air paint stripping heat gun, or you could use a fan heater or possibly a hairdryer. So make sure the device is shut down. Now remove the battery cover. Take out your battery and your SIM card. And make sure you remove the micro SD memory card. Now, using your small Phillips screwdriver, you need to undo 7 of these silver screws around the outside. Don't worry about getting these mixed up, as these are all the same size. You can skip this or any other stage by clicking the link at the top of the video. Now we can remove the rear housing. If you push from the battery compartment from behind, you can lift the screen away from the casing and gently move the case around so the headphone socket releases from the housing. This contains a few antennas. This one's for your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and this is the GPS antenna in your vibrating module. This is the 3G and GSM antenna. If you're replacing the rear housing, you need to lift this out of your old damaged one and put that aside. Then take your new housing and just replace that back in again. If you're only replacing the rear housing, you can reassemble from this stage. This is a moisture indicator which changes colour if it gets wet. And make sure your new housing has this rubber gasket for the USB socket. If you need to replace the loudspeaker or the headphone socket, then we need to lift the main board away from the front housing. Start by lifting the main microphone away, and then using a thin bladed screwdriver, carefully lift the volume switch away from the casing. Try and keep the double-sided tape on the back of the switch. Come around to the other side and gently lift the power switch away from the casing. Again, try and keep the double-sided tape on the back of the switch. Now we can disconnect the forward-facing camera and proximity sensor. And gently lift the main board up from this side. Take it nice and slow, as the screen is still connected to the main board. and using a thin plastic tool, like a guitar pick or this plastic knife, gently disconnect the screen cable. If you need to replace the power switch, you'll need to use a fine tip soldering iron to solder these connections. To replace the main camera, gently disconnect it and take your replacement and plug it back in again. If you need to replace the headphone socket or the loudspeaker, then unplug the flex cable and using a thin screwdriver, gently ease this clip through the main board. And once that's released, you can replace that. If you need to replace the volume switches, again, you can use a fine tip soldering iron to solder the connections. This is the home button switch and the LED backlights for the touch keys, your micro SD tray. This is the main microphone, which can be replaced using a soldering iron. And this is the connection for your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth antenna, and this one for the GPS antenna. The USB socket can be replaced using a hot air soldering iron. And the SIM card tray can also be replaced by using hot air to melt all the connections at the same time. To remove the forward-facing camera and proximity sensor, lift this small bracket up from this end and make sure that the small plastic spacer stays in place and gently lift that away from the casing. This is the proximity sensor, and if you're replacing the earpiece, you may have to switch this rubber gasket over to your new one. Make sure you don't lose this or forget to change it over, otherwise your screen will go blank during voice calls. When you put it back on, make sure it sits down nicely. It's important the sensors cannot see each other and that the gasket is pushed right up against the screen. Before we remove the digitizer from the metal frame, we need to disconnect it. So gently flip this little bar up. And then you can lift the ribbon away. Now we need to get the screen nice and hot. So switch on your heat source. And the ideal temperature we're looking for is somewhere between 70 and 75 degrees C. So use some gloves so you don't burn your hands. And get the screen and the casing nice and hot. And using a thin plastic blade, start separating the glass screen from the metal frame. Don't worry if the home button falls out, we can put that back later. If your screen is quite badly broken, you can put tape across the screen to stop glass splinters from going everywhere. Keep the screen in the hot airflow all the time. If it gets cold, you'll find the adhesive gets very stiff and it's very hard to separate. If you think this looks too difficult, you can buy a replacement screen assembly and then you won't need to perform any of this. All you need to do is switch over your main board and your earpiece over to your new screen. Take your time and don't rush. Just keep working your way around the outside edge. So here the knife has gone between the glass screen and the plastic digitizer. And finally, we have the glass screen separated from the digitizer. Now I'm lifting the digitizer away from the frame. As this is my first time replacing this screen, I was being careful not to damage the LCD display. And here I'm being careful in case there's any touch key ribbon flexes around. But on this Galaxy Ace, the touch keys are done on the digitizer, so you don't have to worry about any flex cables getting damaged. So now the adhesive is getting cold, it's getting more difficult to peel away. It's better to use some heat. And I'll put my gloves back on again. And once it's nice and warm, you can see the adhesive releases quite a lot easier. So try and avoid touching the LCD screen, if you can help it. Keeping it nice and hot makes it easier to remove all the adhesive. So remove as much as you can. And this tape that I'm pulling off here comes with the new digitizer. If you need to replace the LCD display, then while the screen's hot, you'll find it a lot easier to remove. So keeping it nice and warm, you can push the screen from here. And once the screen's lifted enough, you can gently lift the screen away from the metal frame. So make sure the display is nice and clean. Here I'm using some isopropanol alcohol, or you could use a domestic window cleaner. So after using some domestic window cleaner, that's looking nice and clean. You can use some air duster to get rid of any dust that might be on there. And now we need to remove any traces of adhesive that are left on this frame. You can remove the speaker grill if you want to give that a clean. And just keep running around the edges, making sure that all the adhesive is removed. These are the light diffusers for the LED backlights. When you finish removing all the adhesive, you can replace the display. Just place that through and try not to touch the screen. Just give it a gentle push down into place. Now take the new digitizer. And before you remove the double-sided protective film from the tape, make sure it lines up and sits down okay. Now remove the protective film. And if you have an air duster, just make sure there's no dust or hairs trapped in between the two screens. And feed the ribbon flex through. And just a final dust off to make sure there's no dust in there. And line up the speaker grill at the top. And before you push it down fully, just peel off the protective film and see if you can see any trapped hairs. There's one just here. So you can use a pair of tweezers. Remove that hair. Unless you're using a clean room environment, it's going to be very difficult not to have a little bit of dust or hair trapped in between the screens. So you can keep checking. See if there's any dust or hair trapped in there. And if there is, you can open it up and try and remove it. Once you're satisfied that there's no dust or hair trapped, you can push the screen down into place. Make sure the ribbon cables are not trapped. Now replace the earpiece and proximity sensor. And make sure that rubber gasket is sitting down nicely and it's round the correct way. It's important the proximity sensor is pushed right up against the glass, otherwise the screen will go blank during voice calls. And place that bracket in this end first and push that down until it locates in place. Now reconnect the digitizer. Just lift that little flap up. And make sure that goes all the way in, so the white line lines up with the line on the circuit board. then push that back down. Now we can replace the home button. And before we replace the main board, we need to replace the loudspeaker. So line that up onto the main board, pushing that small clip into place. And then reconnect that flex cable. Now we can plug the screen back into the main board. So line that up with the socket and gently push down until you feel it snap into place. Now bring the main board down. Make sure this flex cable isn't trapped and that the microphone and the power and volume keys are not trapped between the board and the frame. Now we can replace the microphone. So slide that in both sides. Now push the volume keys down. And try and line up the edge with the edge of the frame so it sits down nice and flat. Get a firm push down into place. Now reconnect the secondary camera and proximity sensor. Now put the power switch back down. Again, give that a nice firm push to stick it in place. Once you're satisfied everything's in place, we can put the rear cover back on. Make sure you remove the protective film from the camera lens. And just double check that you've put the 3G and GSM antenna in place. Now, starting from the top, line up the micro USB port and the headphone socket. Once you have that lined up, you'll find the rest of the case pushes down nice and easy into place. Now we can replace those 7 screws. Now replace your SIM card and your micro SD memory card. Replace the battery. Put your battery cover back on. we now have a fully restored Galaxy Ace 5830. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch this. Please subscribe and give me a thumbs up, and I shall do my best to make some more.